y'all ready to do this?
Yo, what's up, guys?
Sam's just gonna run up the rocky stairs. What? Movie night. I'm a bad dad. All right, so we finished up the Disney Museum. I run the battery out of my GoPro, which I will be glad to get rid of. GoPro's on the way out for me. And we are now marching up the Champs-Élysées. No, I don't know what street we're on, but we're heading for the Rocky Stairs. Because when in Philly, go to the Rocky Stairs, right? Any thoughts on our museum? Anyone? Augustus, what did you think of the Disney Museum? Great, thanks for your thoughts. Thanks for being involved. Seamus, what did you think of the Disney Museum?
Cool.
Yeah, it was pretty neat. I just like seeing things that Walt has touched. That he's held in his hands. I just like to add a little Charlotte flavor into my videos. Here in the city of brotherly love. And the only one who's not brotherly is my daughter. Look! A bus! Oh wait, no. Look! That guy's thinking about something. I wonder why Charlotte won't be in that videos. It's probably what he's thinking. So much art here in Philadelphia. This is how I'm gonna start and end all my videos. Charlotte casually strolling through Philadelphia. The world is her oyster. Trying not to look back and see what I'm doing. Seamus, unafraid. Charlotte, scared to pieces. Buffalo.
Oh, no, my hair.
The moose. Mooses? Mises? Now check this out. One day back in Philly, four guys wanted to see. They came up to mess up, but what's your name? Woo! Look where I'm going, I guess. Although that would have been really funny. I don't know much about this fountain. Where's the alligator? Oh, yeah.
This guy gets three animals, and the rest of them only get one animal.
Huh. That guy's got a snake over there. Doesn't she have a snake? First one to the top gets 10 bucks. Do your arm. You didn't make it to the top. All right, let's get the pan like the movie. You just look out over the city, guys. Put your arms in the air. Ba-bum-bum. Do it, Sam. Do it, Charles. Clear winner. What's that? Yeah, dig in. Let's see what we think. Charlie, you want me in charge of filming?
Since you don't like.
How is it?
How is it?
Can we get a word?
Oh, that's right. So close to being. All right, we're starting here. Starting here, Pat. I guess we gotta get more cheese beans too.
Yeah.
Here's some napkins.
Pretty solid. So as usual, I didn't do a great job. I'm not a good planner for these videos, but some flavor here, no pun intended. Pat's was opened in the 30s at a hot dog cart, and then they went and bought some cheap steak, sliced it up, onions and some cheese, and then opened this restaurant in the 40s. So this has been around a long time. It is now run by the nephew, who has kept things going here right across the street from Gino's there. His name was Frank. He happened to be right there. He was a super nice guy. We hung around, tried to stay out of the way, but as he was walking by, we ended up getting a picture, which looked like this. There we are. My lips look weird. I don't know why, but that's what I'm stuck with. It was a great sandwich. We had it with provolone, and I will tell you that as we went across the street to Gino's, I've realized that the Cheese Whiz is what I like much better, which was quite shocking to me. So Gino's is right across the street. This is a really cool little area with a lot of Philly flavor. We really enjoyed being down there. And I think both these places are open 365 days a year. So, you know, maybe you could make this your Christmas tradition to run down and have your own competition of Pat's and Gino's. I like them both. Here's the Gino's slice.
We've moved across the street now from Pat's, where we met the owner. I haven't seen the owner come out and say hello here yet. So Gino's, we're moving on to Cheesesteaks. That's pretty good too.
I think the meat here is tender.
I'm pretty enthusiastic about both these places.
I'm already saying this is better. I just think it's juicier.
Done.
Okay. I loved them both. I think the Cheese Whiz is better. Gino's has like longer steak, Pat's is more chopped up, but since Pat came out and was awesome and gave us sandwiches, I'm definitely giving the nod of who I'd go back to first with.
Now we're strolling, I guess this is South Philly. See what else is down here. Taking a little survey of the streets here. But I think we might have to go get a cannoli. We'll probably want to bring Mommy down to check it out.
Then we walked down here to kind of check out what this street was like and what was going on. There's some shops and stuff, man. It's got a really cool vibe. Again, Philadelphia, everyone was just so friendly. It was unbelievable. But we turned around and went back after a little.
From the other end. Might as well.
El Rey de Taco.
Ray's happy birthday bar. I wonder if it has to be your birthday to go in there.
Billion birthdays, or are there only 365?
I don't know.
What do you think?
Think about it. Is this the spot? All right, let's check it out. Frozen cannoli. Holy cannoli. All right, we're rolled out of the King Cannoli here. And the twins are modeling pistachio, which came highly recommended, and St. Patty's Day, because St. Patty's Day. There goes Frank right there. He just came out and hooked us up with a couple of sandwiches. Where'd they go? Look. So now Pat's is my favorite. So we're gonna have to roll with that. All right, we're back in the car. We've done Pat's, Gino's, Cannoli King, and Insomnia Cookies. Everybody, Pat's or Gino's?
Gino's. It seems that
I was born to chart the evening sky. I think it's apples and oranges. I think they're two different sandwiches. Yeah, Pat's were a little cold, but we got two free ones, so that's nice. The owner came out and his wife gave us two free sandwiches for being so pleasant. This is the friendliest city I've ever been in. So, God bless you, Philadelphia. It really is spectacular. But I think if I had to pick, it's too tough. It's just, it's not one's better than the other. They're just very different sandwiches. So that's my review. We all have our own choices. We're gonna eat these cannolis off camera because it's not a date food. It's not something you want to see happen. And we'll report back later here from the city of brotherly love. Like and subscribe. All right, guys, thanks for watching. And don't forget, there's still time to win this amazing, brand new Disney 100 exhibit Corkcicle. When I hit 150, I'll pick one lucky random subscriber. So all you gotta do is hit that subscribe button, join the channel. You don't have to watch anymore, and I still have a chance to win this. So watch another video, like and subscribe. Thanks a bunch for sticking around this long, and good luck.